Hello friends, the teacher here. In Microsoft Excel, you can use custom views to save specific display settings and can create multiple custom views per worksheet. For different custom views, you can specify different column widths or row heights, can hide row and columns, can apply different page layout and margins, and even can apply different filters for different custom views. So keep watching this video to know how to use custom views in your day-to-day tasks. Welcome back, and now let's see how to use custom views. For this Excel worksheet, most of the time, I have to hide certain columns like the discount, profit, and unit price columns. And later on, I have to unhide all the hidden columns. As I spent a lot of time working on this worksheet for my daily routine work, I have to hide and unhide specific columns many times in a day. So what I can do here is, I can create two separate views for this worksheet, then I can easily switch between different views and I no longer need to hide and unhide columns again and again. To do this, first I will create a full worksheet custom view, where no special setting has been applied. To create a custom view, click the View tab from the ribbon, and then click Custom View. From the Workbook View section, click the Add button, and then specify a name for the custom view. Like I would like to give it a name, Full View. Below you can specify that do you want to include print, hidden rows, columns and filter setting in this view if there are any. As I am creating a full worksheet view and want to include all the special settings in this view, so I will remain them checked. And later when I will switch between different views, Excel will remember the settings of different view and I don't want to exclude anything from any custom view. You can uncheck these options if you don't want to include these settings in a particular custom view. Click the OK button and we now have full worksheet custom view available. As I said earlier, I need to hide and unhide certain columns while working on this worksheet. So what now I will do is to hide those columns and will then create another custom view with hidden columns. So first I hide those specific columns and then create another custom view and name it like no profit. So the next time, whenever I need to hide or unhide those columns, I can switch between full view or no profit custom views. And I no longer need to hide or unhide same columns again, which ultimately saves me on time. Let's see another example. In the same worksheet, first I apply the filter and then I apply filter to see only the records of British Columbia in provinces column, which I have to deal with most of the time. Now I create another custom view and name it British Columbia. So the next time, let's say that when I will be working in full worksheet view and I need to see only the British Columbia records, then I don't have to apply the filter again. I can just switch to the British Columbia custom view. As a last example, we see this worksheet where I need to specify two different page settings. So I will create two custom views for this worksheet. For the first custom view, I want the page setting to remain exactly the same, which are page size A4, margins normal, and page orientation portrait. So I create a custom view and name it full sheet display view. The second view for this worksheet is required for printing purposes. So I change the page setting accordingly to horizontally fit the contents on a single page. After defining the settings as required, I create another custom view and then name it Printing. So the next time, I can switch between both these views when I need to see and edit the records, I can use the Display view. And when I need to print this worksheet, I can switch to the Printing view. A few times, I need to work with both Order Summary and Pending Order Workbook together while viewing them side by side. So I create a custom view for this as well. Later, whenever the next time I need to view both workbooks side by side, then I can change to custom view from the workbook in which I had created the custom view. So that is how the custom views can save you on time when you rapidly need to define certain views, page and filter setting on one or more workbook at the same time. Hope you will find this video informative. Tell us by leaving your comments, hitting the thumbs up button and sharing this video with your friends. subscribe us or move to our channel page to watch some more of the teacher's lessons.